We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Sheena, Queen of the Jungle, Issue 9. This is the second to last issue of the 2017 series, written by Marguerite, Bennett, and Christina Trujillo, art by Maria Sanapo and Vincenzo Acunzo, color by Ceci de la Cruz, letters by Thomas Napolitano. I have cover A by Maria Sanapo and Ceci de la Cruz. The executive editor was Joseph Rybrandt, associate editor Anthony Marquez. Sheena reboot by Stephen E. D'Souza. Okay, so we start out with a really, really terrible one-page spread where some soldiers are fighting the monster that was unleashed from the temple. I didn't really have a problem with the monsters. They look goofy, but whatever. I've seen stupider things. Liro and Chano are trying to escape, but they get trapped anyway, and the soldiers try and keep them at gunpoint. Sheena tells them to run, but of course they don't listen, and they end up getting stuck. Meanwhile, the bad guys are trying to get out of the facility as well, and they know that if the thing gets out, it's going to be a real problem for them. Plus, the military, apparently, that they had been bribing is on the way to raid the facility anyway. There are a few other surprises in store for Sheena and her friends, and they're probably not very good. Ends on a really good cliffhanger, and I'd have to say this issue was actually pretty decent as far as action goes. Sheena is portrayed way too impulsively, in my opinion, in this series and too amateurish and juvenile, but overall it's not a bad story. It's just a little trite because we've kind of already seen this one with the first story arc, which in my opinion was a little bit better than this. But if you can find this at a dollar or less, it's worth picking up. It's an okay story. It's not gonna blow you away, but it's far from the worst thing I've ever read. It's just a fairly middle of the road book, but it's not something I would seek out per se, but it's probably worth picking up out of a 50 cent bin or a quarter box or whatever. Something for a dollar or less, you probably won't feel too cheated. Not Dynamite's greatest work, but definitely not their worst. The art does suffer quite a bit from being a little amateurish at times. Some of the panels definitely show improvement by the artist, so I think the artist has some potential. It just needs a little more refinement, and it definitely needs somebody to kind of guide them and give them some editorial oversight. But the perspective shots are good. It's very action-packed, very dynamic, so I'll give them some credit on that. So still not the worst I've read, but not the greatest. But if you find it cheap, I'd say pick it up. Otherwise, it's not worth the cover price. It's not something I'm going to seek out and trade paperback, but like I said, if you find it cheap, it might be something to kill some time. It's fairly safe. There's not a lot of swearing or anything. I didn't see any of that I can recall. So it's a fairly decent book for teenagers. It is fairly violent, but beyond that, nothing particularly offensive. So I will recommend it, but it's a recommendation only if you can find it very cheap. But with that being said, that's just my take. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to support the channel in other ways, links are in the description and on the about page, and we hope to see you on the next one.